Hello.
Hello.
Hello, Fabien. How are you?
Good, good. Oh, nice, nice background.
Nice place. It's my new workplace since the COVID problem, you see. Thanks for joining us on this OCA Days. This is very much appreciated. I think your first time you were part of the OCA event was on the year of its foundation a couple of years ago. So I'm happy to see you back there. It will be time to start your speech. I just try to check with Alexandre. This is you checking that Fabien got the right to present and
I
speak
think I have.
properly.
I
You
think
have
I
all
have a
the
share
things.
screen button.
Okay, so I don't think I need much introduction for you. Owner of Odoo, being part of that adventure since so many years now. It's a pleasure for us to get you for a talk today. So I hand over the speech to you. Again, thank you for joining us.
Yeah, thank you for inviting me. I think it's 15 years now, so it starts
Yeah.
to be long. So hi everyone. So I'm Fabien. I'm the founder of Odoo. I'm the CEO of the company too. I'm originally a developer, but I'm more a product owner nowadays. So I don't develop that much, but I spend a lot of my time improving the product, working with the developers or the product owners. And my talk today is about the relationship with OCA. So I'll try to be fast on the talk. Do you see my screen? Yes, I believe so.
Yes, it's okay.
Perfect. So here we go. And I'll start with the obvious things, but sometimes I like to remind the obvious things because with time people get scared of things and whatever. So let's start with the obvious. I'd like to repeat that, but we do love our product, the Odoo community product. Not talking about the people. I do love the people too. We really like the Odoo community product, like a father, because it's our product. It's our. So sometimes I hear people who say that we want to reduce it or whatever. It's not like you have to imagine that it's our product. We wanted to make it the best open source management software. It's like we are a father for this product. So we want the best for our Odoo community and open source version of Odoo on the product. We also like and love the OCA, but it's different. It's not like a father, it's like a colleague, or I would say a colleague of a different department, because we don't really work together, but we like each other's. I believe OCA likes what we do, not all the time, but most of the time. And it's the same for us. We believe that there is a big contribution to the ecosystem of Odoo done by the OCA. It's just that we perceive it as a colleague from a different department. We all do our own job. We are happy that everyone does its job, but we focus on what we have to do. And that's the way today the relationship is. Of course, we might improve some of the things, but that's something we can discuss after. And I'd like to emphasize on that because even when the OCA develop things that are, I would say, against our Odoo Enterprise product, like Open Upgrade or accounting feature, we like it too. I believe it's good to have some competition. It's good that the users have the choice. I mean, there are some users in the world that don't have the money to, or they have, for philosophical reason, want to stay on open source, and it's good that they have a service to upgrade or could access some of the accounting features. So we are not against all those things neither. I think it's good for me that we address everyone on the market. There are some people who are ready to pay a little bit to get a better software with the enterprise, and there are some people who prefer to spend more time and pay maybe more in the implementation time, but less in the license, and go with the OCA with Open Upgrade and accounting. And I think that this is great. This is great because part of our model is to have a huge community with a lot of millions of people using the software, and having the OCA contributes to that. It's a very good thing for us. It's, you know, yeah, there is a lot of company who have a free product and a paid for product. I believe our approach is even better. We have a free product, Odoo Community, and a paid for product with Odoo Enterprise. But we have also tools for the to upgrade the free product for the ones who really don't want Odoo Enterprise. So I think it's good. I think by doing that, we have an offer for everyone in the world, and that's the point of Odoo, is to improve every company in the world. I know some of our salespeople might not happy sometimes because they lose a deal because of that, but at the end, we don't care. What matters is to have millions of users. Because we have millions of users, we all will be successful. And it's very important because all of this contributes to having a very rich and unique ecosystem, I believe. I don't think there are a lot of open source product who has that many things in their ecosystem. So if we look at Odoo, there is, of course, as in terms of product, the Odoo community product with all its modules. And then I could have inverted these boxes, but and then we have the community modules from the OCA or other contributors, and then the enterprise. And that creates a lot of variety of options for our users, and that's great. Of course, some people prefer to go with full community, others prefer to use OCA or other third-party modules, others prefer enterprise, and that's good, I think, because it allows us to reach millions of users rather than 100K users. And the thing which is important, if we want to transform a market, we don't only need a good product. We also need great services and a lot of resources, because we have so many people working on Odoo today that we need to be sure that these guys are trained so that they get good service. And the OCA contributes a lot there too. Maybe not in the umbrella of the OCA, but mostly because we have a huge community of partners, but also community members who sell, develop, or offer services, consulting services on Odoo. And that's very important. We won't be able to compete against the proprietary software if we wouldn't have a global, worldwide service offer. And the contribution here is important too, and the resources too, because we have estimated 80,000 people are full-time working on Odoo, developing the software, selling it, or doing services. Half of them are in the partner network, half of them is in the community, not partners. So we do need a lot of resources to train these guys, provide tools they need, and so on. And by working together, we provide more. We have the official resources like the e-learning, scale-up, the documentation, the forum. But OCA contributes also with events like this one to advertise or teach or help people, educate people. And we also have resources for teachers and others, but that's another community. I used to say that we have a lot of communities. OCA, or I would say the more technical communities, developers are one. But we also have a community of teachers, very different. Their contribution is very important too, but it's different. They don't provide code. They just educate the market and the students. And we also have communities of accountants that follow us, specifically accounting firms now. We work with a lot of accounting firms in Europe, and we created some discussion group with them. And it's great to have all these people around us. Of course, it's not easy because everyone has different expectations. So we try to do our best to set up the tools so that everyone can be satisfied with Odoo. And I will explain how we do that now. Why does it work? How did we succeed to have communities of developers, of accountants, of teachers, very different people? I believe we are probably the only open source product. There are a lot of open source products where there is with a developer community. But ours is much complex because we are in the business management software. So why did it work? And I believe there are four reasons that we decided at the beginning of the Odoo that makes this a success. One is the modularity of Odoo. The modularity of Odoo, being able to create modules, allows to reduce friction. If we wouldn't have the modules, every contribution should be a pull request where we have to decide if we put it in the main product or not. And that would create a lot of frictions. With the modularity of Odoo, everyone is free to create a module. It's easy to distribute. And you could even have several modules for the same thing. So if someone doesn't like the CRM of Odoo, he can create his own CRM and publish the module, and we'll see the one who's the best use, and we can use this one. So the modularity of Odoo plays a lot, and there are a lot of there are a lot of software in the open source world that do not have the power or the easiness of the Odoo modules, and I think it helped us a lot to work together. It's the reason why OCA and Odoo can work separately, and we still contribute to the same ecosystem without having to discuss too much. And it's good, because if we have to discuss too much to take every decision and accord ourselves, align ourselves on every decision, that would create a lot of frictions. With the technical modularity of Odoo, we can all do whatever we want, and the users decide what they want to use, and that's great. Another one is that we have aligned the interest. I think we get to a point where Odoo satisfies pretty much everyone's interest. The partners are profitable. Us, Odoo SA, we are profitable. The users have a very good software for a low price. And the community benefits year after year from better features, a product that evolves very fast, and extra modules from the OCA or other community member. So we have a mechanism where now everybody receives, and that's great. One thing which is important too is that we succeeded to have like a dual governance, and I think it's great. There are some of the decisions we did here at Odoese that a traditional open source governance would never have done. And I think it's important that we did it. It's what allowed Odoo to be what it is today. And on the other hand, the OCEA can have its own governance. And the fact that we are all free and there is a big freedom and independence between the different communities and contributors and so on, it helps a lot reducing the friction and allowing everyone to produce what he wants easily and build its own way of working. And I think is important. And that's one of the reasons I do not participate that much in the OCEA. It's because I don't want to influence the OCEA. I think it's good that you have your own governance, your own freedom to do whatever you want. And I don't want to try to influence that. I don't want to have all interests mixed with your interests. I think it's good that you focus on your governance, on your interest. We do the same for us. And all in all, we all benefit from what we both do. And at the end, it's probably the most important, it works because it's sustainable. I mean, everyone is profitable. The OCEA is a sum of companies. I would say that most of them are companies that are profitable. We are profitable, the users benefit from that. So because of this, we have the money we need to make the things evolve. And that's very important. So those are for me the four elements why the ecosystem of Odoo is working and why OCEA and Odoo.se and other communities in different countries are very successful. This is one of the reasons, that's a question I often have, why don't Odoo.se participate or is involved to the OCEA? In my opinion, it's good that everyone has its own responsibilities. My responsibility or the responsibility of Odoo.se is to build the best product, open source product ever. That's what we do. And I'm 100%, I would say maybe 200%, but 100% dedicated to that. And I refuse to do everything else. I refuse to be invited in events. I never participate to board of companies. I have requests every week. And for the same reason, I don't participate too much in the OCEA because I don't consider it's my responsibility. My responsibility is the product you download on Odoo.com. And I think it's good that the responsibilities of OCEA is different and come to complement what we do. It's a matter of focus. I don't want to defocus myself too much. So 100% of our resources are working on the product. And also, it's because I like the fact that people are independent and having different associations that are independent because I think it reduces frictions. Even though it doesn't mean that we should not collaborate and discuss more, we are always very happy to discuss and collaborate on topics. So we are very active on the localization of the different countries working with the community. We had a discussion last week with Joël about the inventory management where we discussed the great modules they developed. So from time to time, we collaborate when we need or when the OCEA need. We are always open to discuss and be there if you want information from us. To continue on the complex topics, let's explain the community and enterprise. But before that, I will re-explain why we came to that model. Because, you know, I'm a developer. I was passionate about open source. I'm still one of my goals in life is to produce a lot of good open source tools. And so I always refused the open core approach until recently. And I will re-explain why we had to pivot on the business model, because we still have a lot of questions and frustrations due to that. And it all comes down to this graph that was the cash of our company in 2014. We raised 8 million of euro, so we could recruit developers to do what we wanted in the product. And as you see, very quickly in end of 2015, we only had 2 months of cash available. So basically, we could sustain the R&D with VC money, but we couldn't be profitable with the open source model we get to. And just before, it was exactly the same graph with our first fundraising. So we had to change something. There was no way we could finance the R&D of the product living from services. The margins on services are way too low to do what we do. So we had to pivot on another business model. So even though I refused to do an open core, I had to. And so then we switched to the open core model for version 9. And then we survived because of that. And we could even get cash that goes in after 1 year, so we could recruit more developers to improve the product. So it basically saved our own company and our ability to invest in the product, because both are very linked. And that's for my perspective, our company, but for the point of view of the community, because we are aligned, the impact is exactly the same. So this is the graph of the number of developers we had working in R&D, just working on the product of the community. In 2014, before the open core business model where we were fully open source, and in 2018, 4 years after. Today we have much more. But and as you can see, even though we split it before we were fully open source, in 2018, we were 80% open source, 20% working on proprietary features like the accounting. The net is that we could increase the number of developers working on the open source product by 4 times, something we struggled to do over the past. So even though you might feel that because we have enterprise, we spend less time in the community version of Odoo, or in Odoo community, the open source version of Odoo, it's actually not true. It's because we have the enterprise version that we can recruit way more developers that improve the product so that we can contribute much more to the open source world. Because what matters is not the percentage of people that works on open source, is the absolute number of contributions you do. And we could multiply that a lot. And then the trend continued. So today we have more than 200 developers dedicated to the R&D. We have way, way more than that, but if I only count the ones dedicated to the R&D, it's 200. So all in all, the switch was very positive. I was even surprised myself to see that. Initially it was to survive and keep the company alive, but at the end it turns out to be a much better model than what I thought, and it's actually the best I could find for Odoo, and we are very happy with it now. Even if we only look at the perspective of the open source product, it's, I believe, the best model too. Of course, there are always trade-offs. You cannot put 100 developers like that on the product without having a small trade-off. We have a trade-off on the accounting, which is in enterprise. But the pros and the cons, the pros are much more important than the cons, I believe. And so now we can make this statement that our goal is to make Odoo Community, the open source product, the best open source software for all its applications. So we want to have the best CRM, the best website builder, the best inventory management, the best MRP in open source. We don't have the best ERP because it's not an app of Odoo Community, it's an app of enterprise accounting, but it's still a massive contribution to open source to be able to bring a product that has the potential to be the best CRM, the best inventory, sale, manufacturing, purchase, website builder, e-commerce. It's massive contribution, and we're very happy with that. For some application, it's already the case. I believe we already have the best CRM and sale, purchase, inventory by far. For others, it's not yet, but we are working hard and it's gonna be very soon. For the website builder, it's the case since version 14. Before we were less good than Squarespace, I believe, in the website builder space. Now we are better. And that's why we say what's in community stays in community and what's in enterprise stays in enterprise. And I've had a few questions from the OCA about that, people saying that it's not true. So I think I should explain what we mean by that. What we mean by that, it's from an end user point of view. It's more about the features. Do we add or remove features? So what we mean is that it's a mindset for us. We have no plan to turn an open source feature into proprietary. We have no plan at all. We have no long-term strategy of doing that. I mean, our strategy is to continue to do what we have always done because it works. So all the community apps stays and will stay in the community. All the future improvement on these apps, all the R&D we'll do will also be open source. What it does not mean is that all objects and methods will remain from one version to another, because at the end, the product has to evolve. We have to clean code, we have to remove, we have to change things. So we do our role of product managers, and we are okay to break things to make a better product at the end. So it does not mean that things get not removed. For the same way we do with enterprise, we also remove things in enterprise if we consider it's not good enough. It's a matter of being focused on doing the right things. Sometimes you have to refactor. It does not mean that feature will not be removed from the community. If we consider that a feature is not good enough, we might remove it for the benefits of the others, because maintenance costs a lot. And the more we are focused, the best product we can do. So the overall idea is the one we want the community to evolve, but we still do good product management. So we are ready to break stuff. We are okay to remove features or code or change, but it's always for the good. And we do the same for enterprise. If we consider that a feature is not good enough, we might remove it. Of course, we try to avoid. So if you look at the 1,000 plus tasks we have done for version 14, pretty much all of them were not about removing something. Maybe a few ones were, but most of them are not, because we try to avoid. But it's the life of a product to evolve. And when you have evolution and innovation, things change. Otherwise, you don't evolve. So why did we remove account fiscal year from Odoo community? I have to say I don't have the answer, because I was not aware of that three days ago. But I'm pretty sure it's something around the lines of because it was an object that was, for us, dead code in Odoo community, because the invoicing application, which is in Odoo community, did not use this object. So for us, it was dead code in Odoo community. And when we had to refactor the accounting in enterprise, it was probably easy for the developers to have all the code in the same repository, rather than splitting the legacy code that stays in community and creating new ones in enterprise that inherits. So it was, I believe, a matter of simplicity. But for sure, it was not a plan for us to reduce community. It was also because we think in terms of users more than in terms of developers. What matters for us is the user. Do we remove something for the user? And for us, we did not remove something for the user, because Odoo invoicing does not use fiscal years. Having said that, this is not a golden rule. It's just a mindset. We sometimes break the exceptions. So I don't think we break the rule in Odoo 14, but we did it in Odoo 13. That was the slides of the Odoo experience 2 years ago. And at the time, we changed. So there were some enterprise features that became open source. We have the list here. As some open source feature that became enterprise, you have the list here. Why did payroll become enterprise? Because we consider that as an end user point of view, we had no feature. It was not usable. Nothing was working, was on par with traditional payroll software in the market. And in order to make it usable, we had to invest massively in the localization in the different countries. It's a huge amount. So the only way for us to do that, like the accounting, to get to the level of traditional payroll software, was to make it enterprise so that we value it. But we consider that it was not a big removal, because it was just not usable as it is. Yeah, as a framework, maybe it was usable, but not for the end user. And all in all, I think in the balance, we put more in the open source ones, because those were more interesting features than the ones we put there. So it was always, deciding for the good, what I believe. Of course, if you nitpick and say, okay, we still remove something from community, but if you look at the big picture, usually we do for the good of the open source project, not usually always. And I'll finish with demystifying a few myths, some of the things I hear in the community that are just that are plain wrong. So it's sometimes good to remind yourself about that. And let's go for some of them. I know that a lot of people are afraid of VCs, that they think that it's not good for the open source, or when a VC invests in a company, the company will be forced to, monetize more or things like that. From my experience, it's not the case at all. VCs don't care about open source or not. They just care that the company runs well. And usually when they bring money in the company, it's good for the open source company, because it gives us more time to invest in R&D and also to find this good business model. For us, at least, for Odoo, if we wouldn't have had VC money, we'd probably be dead way before. We could survive a few years to get cash until we pivot on the business model, because we had VC money. And never ever the VC have questioned the open source model of Odoo. When we changed the open source to the open core model, it's because I decided, not them. So I think they are good just because they provide money. And I don't think they are evil in the sense that they don't like open source. Actually, I think that if they invest in an open source company, it's because they believe in the model. Otherwise, they won't invest in it. And what about open core? Some people think it's bad. Some people think it's good. I believe it also depends on the company. There are very good open core companies like GitLab or Nginx. And there are some where it didn't work well, like SugarCRM or OpenBravo. So at the end, it's not about the model, it's about the company. And most of the time when the company failed, it was not because of the business model. It was because they didn't succeed to create a good product. For me, that was the reason why OpenBravo failed, is because the product was not usable. It's not because they had VC, it's not because they had OpenCore. It's just that at the end, you need a great product. And if the company doesn't succeed to do that, the company is forced to pivot until it survives, until it succeeds to create a great product. So it's always because of the product. That's it. I think I'm good. Do we have time for the questions or not? Maybe one or two, not more.
Yeah, no problem. At the end of the day, we have an Ask Me Anything session just now, so we can stay a few more minutes with you to get that. So I don't know who is going to get any question here. I'm checking that.
Okay, I have a question from Frederick.
Yes.
It's long, so can everyone read the question or not?
Yes, yes, everyone can read the question.
I only panelists can see the question, so
it's
limited to the three of us. If we answer it, they will see it.
Yes, I understand what Frederick says. He says if we collaborate more, we can do bigger things. I do agree with that. I think collaboration is good, but we shouldn't influence each other. I mean, it's good that we all have the freedom to do whatever we want. So that's the reason why we choose an open source license. It's to allow everyone to do whatever he wants. So I believe I will agree with Frederick in the sense that if we collaborate more with OCA or other communities or other community members, it's good. But one of the reasons why we don't do it, it's also because for instance, in the past, we used to ask feedback to a community, and we noticed that we were wasting more time than we were actually saving. Because we work in the master version, the future version of Odoo. The community is usually working on the version 12 or version 13 or 14, the current versions of Odoo. So we are not even aligned on what's the current state of the product. So we always waste a lot of time explaining, re-explaining, because the context is not the same. So what we do is we collaborate with the community when we need it. As an example, we do it for the localization. We discuss with Joel for the inventory management. But apart from that, we don't want to communicate for everything, because what matters for me is our efficiency to produce more good open source code rather than to discuss more. I hope it's clear. I hope it answered your question, Frederick.
Cannot tell for him, but I think it was clear. He says he's
watching. But at the end, that's my point of view. We are always happy and open to discuss. So I believe I never refuse the meeting with the CEO. I never refuse to discuss everything. I'm available everywhere, whether it's on LinkedIn, Twitter, or Discord. So it's up to you too to contact us if you have some topics.
Okay, we have another question here about if you're going to release one day the migration script for the partner, just like the enterprise module code.
Yeah, at some point it was our intention. And the migration service helps us a lot in different ways. One is a bit silly, but we have a lot of people who cheat, and we catch them at the migration. And so if we release it for free, we might have issues with that. And at the end, the more we move forward, the more migration is a service. And by releasing the script and people trying on their own, we would lose money. It's a bit like, it costs us more to support an on-premise customer than an online customer. It feels strange because on online, we have to manage the servers and everything. But because it's under control for us, we have less back and forth when we have a ticket. And it's a bit the same with the migration. We have a platform where everything is smooth and fixing issues. We have a lot of automated tools. And if someone tries on its own with our script, it will probably lose way more time in the support and don't offer a quality service. And our goal is to focus on quality service, which is not there yet, but our goal is to reach that.
Okay, thank you. Then we have another question. In what extent the OCA influencing the Odoo developers' best practices, OCA modules, coding standards? I mean, is there any influence within your company from our work or our way of doing things?
No. We are so much focused on what we do that we don't look at all at what the others do. And usually when we need something, we have a good example. We did a job queue recently, and we looked at what the OCA did, but I don't remember a case where we could get information from what I've been doing, at least reuse the code. Sometimes we have ideas. But what happens is not at the OCA level, in the umbrella of it, but at the people level, we do have very good contributors in the localization, in the source of information when we work with partners. So at the end, it's still the OCA, because it's like when we work with Joel, do I work with Joel or the OCA? but it was a very good contribution. So, but on the governance, all governance is very different from the OCA. Odoo is a bit like a dictature where I'm the dictator. It might seem wrong, but actually it's what makes us move much faster than usual.
Okay, thank you. Then we have Rafael Valli that asks if there's any way to help or unlock the Brazilian Portuguese documentation of Odoo, because he thinks now the market there is very huge. So he was thinking, well, if you have a plan for translating the documentation.
I think we should start by the right thing. And the right thing is not the documentation. The right thing is having a correct localization. And once you have a correct localization, we have seen that in pretty much every country, it unlocks the country a lot. So we have done it for Mexico and everything exploded 2 years, 1 year or 2 years ago in Mexico. So for sure, we won't start with the documentation. We have to start by doing a clean localization. And once we have that, I'm pretty sure everything will follow. And that's a matter for working together on that. We did it with the countries where we had very good relationship with partners. So we did it in Colombia with partners, in Mexico, pretty much every country in Latin America. Not in Brazil, but one day maybe.
Okay, thank you. Then maybe a question of me. what could the OCA do to help Odoo SA in any ways? I mean, if you had any recommendation of your own?
I think you should continue doing what you do. What you do is a very good service for our partners, and that helps us indirectly because the more profitable our partners are, the best it is for the Odoo ecosystem. For the product, it's on demand. I think where we have the most need is in the feedback from the localization. We do have a lot of partners who come and say, we want to contribute, we want to help. And usually when we dig in, they don't answer after, or it's very hard to get the right information on localizations. And after that, it's project by project. When we had the refactoring on inventory a few years ago, we contacted. It's really case by case. Apart from that, we have a mindset where we don't use community modules, not related to OCA or not, but at Odoo, we use very few community modules. But it's because we are champions of doing out of the box. So I think the OCA is a better service for the partners than for us.
So that's linked to the last question I received, is about if Odoo actually uses some OCA modules when they do implementation for their own customer?
I think I will rephrase. Do we use community modules? OCA or okay. not, and the answer is pretty much never.
Okay.
Because the pretty customer we do, we are good at doing it everything in standard because we think it costs less. Doesn't mean that I think that the modules are worth nothing. I think the modules are very efficient for the partners because the partners works on mid-sized companies, a bit larger companies, so they might need the modules. But most of the time, I think people waste too much time on custom code that probably is not required for the business.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. But
keep in mind that I don't have the same. I'm very focused on out of the box. The partners, on the other hand, are focused on delivering a very customized service. And for them, the modules are very useful. So in a sense, it's useful for us because if it's useful for the partner, it's good for us. But directly, we don't use them.
Okay. Well, maybe one thing came into my mind is maybe what you can do for us.
Yeah.
I think one of the most questioning thing we had during the board discussion the past weeks was why we still don't have a link to our website on your website. And if there is any reason, we would be happy to hear the why.
So you do have, with the App Store, there are plenty of OCA modules on the App Store and probably the best visibility is there, not everywhere else. I think it's a decision we did a few years ago and we never thought about it recently. I believe, if I remember well, it was a matter of we have so many communities and we didn't want it to put one in front of the others. We have communities in every country. We have the Spanish community, the Italian community. We have some teachers community and so on. And at the time, we decided that it should be based on meritocracy, the one who released the more modules, more visibility. And we didn't saw an interest of trying to promote one versus the other. And I think if we do it one day, we'll probably list all the communities, like index of communities that exist on Odoo, and the OCA would be the main one, it's the best one and the biggest one on the top. But I don't like the fact to say, officially, this is the community and you go there. because for us, the community is the ones that are on the forum, the ones that are on or e-learning. That's the official community. So we don't want to say OC is the official one, because for us, everyone is part, whether they pay a fee to the OC or not. Everyone is part, could be part of our community if they work on TransFX or go to the forum or go to the e-learning.
Yeah, I got that. Okay, I think we have ended up all the questions, unless one of you still have a last minute one. Otherwise, I think we're done.
Thank you, everyone.
Thanks to you, Fabien, for your participation. Wish you all a nice day.
Yeah.
And talk to you soon.
Yes. Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye.